ठीक है। गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू अरोरा ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम हियर विद अ न्यू लेसन फॉर यू एंड द नेम ऑफ दिस लेसन इज इन द किंगडम ऑफ फूल्स बाय ए के रामानुजन। एंड इन द किंगडम ऑफ फूल्स इज ए स्टोरी, इज अ वेरी इंस्पायरिंग स्टोरी एंड दिस इज फ्रॉम योर बुक मोमेंट्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टूडे आई विल गिव यू द डिटेल्ड एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दिस लेसन। लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द ऑथर ए के रामानुजन। एक्चुअली ही वॉज बॉर्न ऑन 16th March 1929 एंड डाइड ऑन 13th July 1993। He was the Indian poet and a scholar of Indian literature. He was a great writer and he wrote in both English and Kannada. He was a poet, a scholar, folklorist, translator and playwright. He was awarded the Sahitya Academy Award, which is the highest award given for literature. So he was awarded the Sahitya Academy Award posthumously, means after his death in 1999, for his collection of poems, the collected poems. So he was awarded the Sahitya Academy Award for his collection of poems, and that is the collected poems. So the collected poems is a collection of poems for which he was awarded the Sahitya Academy Award. Let us talk about the theme of this story. We have wisdom, and wisdom is respected everywhere. Wisdom is worshipped everywhere. When foolishness is our greatest enemy, stupidity is our greatest enemy. When we are in a danger, when we are in troubles, we can come out of the troubles with the help of wisdom that is with us. Actually, with the help of wisdom, we can make a difference between right and wrong. We can easily make a difference between the right and wrong with the help of wisdom. When our life is in troubles, we can fight with them and make our ways with the power of wisdom. And if we have power of wisdom, we can overcome any problem. It lives with us and never dies, even if we leave this world. Obviously, the wise people are worshipped everywhere. So if we have the power of wisdom, we are respected, we are adored, and we are honored everywhere. So those who have the power of wisdom, they can overcome any doubt, they can overcome any fear, and they can overcome any problem that they face. Let us talk about the summary of this story. Actually, in the kingdom of fools, as the very title of this lesson suggests, that it is the kingdom of fools, Murkho ka Raj. Summary of the story, let us go for the guru and the disciple. The first point is the guru and the disciple. In the kingdom of fools, both the king and the minister were idiots. They were fools. In the kingdom of fools, both the king and the minister, means the king's minister, were idiots. They were fools. And they wanted to rule over the kingdom in a different way. They wanted to prove their kingdom a different kingdom, a unique kingdom. So they did not follow other kings. They followed their own rules. So they made a rule. They announced something which is very full of stupidity, and they announced which is quite funny, since it was the kingdom of fools. The king was a big fool. Even the minister was a big fool. They were stupid fellows. So they didn't want, means the king and the minister, that they didn't want to run things like other kings. So they decided to change night into day and day into night. They decided to change the day into night and night into day. Means the day was meant for sleeping and the night was meant for work. One day a guru and his disciple, shishya, chela. So one day a guru and disciple arrived in the kingdom of fools. Both of them, guru and the disciple, both of them arrived in the kingdom of fools. And both of them were very much surprised by what they saw in the kingdom of fools, by what they saw in the city, by what they saw in the town. In the evening, the whole town woke up. The two men were hungry, means both the guru and the disciple, they were hungry, and the shops were open. Actually, they found that everything cost the same. In the kingdom of fools, everything was cheap and everything had the same price. Everything cost the same price and everything was cheap. Bahut sasta. So they were surprised to see that everything was cheap, number one. At the same time, they were surprised to see when everything was cheap and everything had the same price. Means you can get everything at a cheap rate, at a cheap price, and you can get everything, for the same price. Means everything was cheap and one has to pay the same price for buying everything. Means everything was cheap and you can get anything for the same price. Means there was the same price for everything. They were delighted, but the guru decided to leave the place as this was a kingdom of fools. The guru was actually a wise person. He was a great scholar. He had a divine power and he understood that there is a danger in the kingdom of fools. So he told his disciple that this place is not fit for them. There is always a danger. There is always a danger ahead. There is always a danger at every step of life if we stay here. So the guru told his disciple, shishya, to go away from there. But the disciple did not want to go away from there. Everything was cheap and he wanted to enjoy everything there. He wanted to eat everything there because everything had the same price. One has to pay the same price for everything and everything was cheap. So the disciple wanted to stay in the kingdom of fools, but the guru warned him that actually there is a danger in this city. There is a danger in this kingdom of fools. Nobody can predict what will happen within a moment. So it is not safe for both of us to stay in the kingdom of fools. So let us go away from here. But the disciple did not go away from there. So the guru decided to leave the place. He decided to go away from the place as this was a kingdom of fools and anything could happen there. But the disciple wanted to stay there and enjoy cheap food. He wanted to eat everything. He wanted to enjoy everything there. Now the disciple in the critical situation, point number two. What happened? One night a burglar, a thief, was killed when a wall fell on him while he was sneaking in at a merchant's house. One night a burglar was sneaking into, he broke into the house of a merchant and he was stealing something from the merchant's house. And for this, he made a hole in the wall. And suddenly the wall fell on him. The wall collapsed on the burglar and the burglar died there. Now, his brother went to the king. The burglar's brother, now burglar was no more. So the burglar's brother went to the king for the justice. He went to the king. And he complained against the merchant for having built a weak house. because the wall was so big, and when the burglar made a hole in the wall to get inside the house of the merchant, all of a sudden the wall fell on the burglar. As a result, the burglar died. Next day, the burglar's brother went to the king and complained against the merchant for making such a weak wall. And then the king summoned the merchant, called the merchant in his court, and told his minister to investigate the matter. The merchant blamed the bricklayer, mason, one who, bricklayer, Rajmistri in Hindi we call it, bricklayer means mason. So, the merchant blamed the bricklayer. The merchant was brought in the court, in the royal court, and he said that he is not responsible for the death of this burglar. Then, who is responsible? The merchant said that the bricklayer, the mason, is responsible for making a weak wall. Then the bricklayer was called in the court. And when the bricklayer was brought before the king, the bricklayer was very afraid and he said that he is not responsible for the death of the burglar. Actually, the dancer is responsible for this. And he said that there was a dancer, and that dancer, the dancing girl is responsible for the death of this burglar. So then again, the dancing girl was also called before the king. And when the dancing girl was called before the king, the dancing girl said that it was due to the goldsmith, because she was going up and down to the goldsmith every now and then, and she was going up and down to the goldsmith, and it was the goldsmith who was calling her many times, but not giving her the jewelry. Then the merchant was, I mean goldsmith was also called. So the dancing girl said that it was the jeweler, goldsmith. It was the jeweler who did not keep his promise, and thus he had to visit him many times. The dancing girl said that it was the fault of the jeweler. The jeweler did not keep his promise, and he called her many a times. And that is why, while going up and down, while coming back, or while going to the goldsmith, and while coming back from the goldsmith, the bricklayer was watching it, and the bricklayer was seeing it, and due to this, the concentration of the bricklayer was, the bricklayer lost his concentration on his work, and that is why he did not make the wall strong. So the goldsmith said that it was because of the rich merchants. Now the goldsmith was also called, and he said that it was because of the rich merchant's order that he could not deliver the things in time. The goldsmith said that this is not his fault, this is the fault of the rich merchant. This is the rich merchant where the burglar crept into, where the burglar went to sneak into, went to steal something from there. And this is the merchant who was called in the beginning by the king. So, rich merchant's order, he could not deliver the things in time. Now, the goldsmith said, the jeweler said that it is not his fault, it is the fault of rich merchant. Ultimately, it was the same rich merchant who was called in the beginning. Finally, the king passed death sentence. Death sentence means death punishment. So finally, the king passed death sentence for the rich merchant. The rich merchant was called and death sentence was passed. But this merchant was so thin. He was so thin that he could not fit the stake. A stake is a kind of gallows for giving the death punishment. In Hindi, suli par chadha dena. So he was so thin. The merchant was called back, and merchant was so thin that he could not fit the stake. Means he was so thin and he couldn't be fitted for the stake. for execution. So the king ordered for a fat man for execution. Since the merchant was thin, so the king ordered for a fat man. Go and bring, just search for the fat man and call the fat man. And if the fat man is fitted to this stake, the fat man should be hanged till death. So the king ordered for a fat man for execution. The soldiers started searching for the fat man, and the soldiers caught the disciple who had become fat by eating a lot. The disciple, the Guru's disciple, Sisya, Chela. So actually he was the disciple stayed there and he was enjoying lots of food, and he had fattened himself. He had become fat by eating so much things by getting at a cheap rate. So the disciple had become very fat. So since the king's soldiers were searching for a fat man to be fit for the death sentence. Now they caught the fat man. And who was the fat man? The fat man was the Sisya, I mean the disciple. Now the disciple was brought back, and the disciple's life was very critical. The disciple was going to be hanged. The disciple remembered his guru and prayed for his help. The disciple remembered the words of guru and prayed to guru for his help. And then the guru, the wise guru, appeared before him with his divine power. The guru befooled the king and the minister that it was the most auspicious time, and whomever would die first would be the future king, and whomever would die next would become the minister. So the guru appeared to save the life of his disciple, because the disciple prayed to his guru for his help, and guru appeared there with his divine power, and both the guru and the disciple started fighting. Then the king asked them as to why they are quarreling. Then the guru was wise. The guru said, "This is the auspicious moment, and we are fighting that who is going to be hanged first. Who is going to be hanged first? We are fighting for this. So this is the most auspicious moment for whomsoever dies first will be the king in future, and whomsoever dies next will be the minister in future. So that is why." We are fighting. Then this tempted the king. The king thought that, oh, this is a good opportunity, and if I go forward, or if I keep myself for the stake first, I'll be the king in future. And if my minister keeps himself for his death next to me, he will be my minister. So the king tempted to go for the stake first. So both of them. Now the king went himself, and then what happened? So the king and the minister decided to die on the same stake. They decided to die. So the king went first, and He was staked, and the minister also went there, and he was also staked. So both the king and the minister staked themselves, and they died. So this is the wisdom. Actually, this was not the guru was wise. Guru saved his disciple from the stupid king and the minister. Now everything became normal. Point number 3: changes in the kingdom of fools. After their death, now the king and the minister, both of them died, and the guru and the disciple were saved. The people of the town requested them to be their king. Now the people of the kingdom, after the death of their king and minister, because they died because they presented themselves to the Aztec and they died. And then what happened? That everything changes, everything changed, everything became normal. Now the people of that kingdom begged the guru to be their king, and begged the disciple to be the minister. So now the guru and the disciple became to be their next king and the minister. So they agreed to it and announced that now the day would be day and the night would be night, and people could get nothing for a single dudu. Everything changed, and he said now the day would be day and the night would be night. Everything became normal, and actually everything, the price of everything will be fixed according to the value of the things. So everything became normal. There was no stupidity. The guru was wise, and the guru saved the life of his disciple. So we should not allow ourselves to be trapped in any grid. And the king, both the king and the minister, both of them were very stupid. They were very fools, isn't it? And the people of the town, the people of the kingdom were afraid of them. So they carried out the order given by the king and the minister. And even the king was very happy at the success of his plan. But now you have seen at last what happens. Both the king and the minister, both of them presented themselves to be estacked, to be hanged for the death. And they themselves died just because of their stupidity. And the guru saved his disciple. The guru not only saved his disciple from such a foolish king and the minister, but the wise guru saved the life of the people of his kingdom. So here the story comes to an end. Thank you very much, dear students. And this is the end of the story. This is all for today. Thank you very much. Till then, keep learning, keep practicing, work very hard at your home. Thank you very much. That's all for today.